Welcome back to another video. Today we will tell you about the best restaurants to visit in London. So before starting, please like the video and subscribe to our channel for future updates. London is one of the most diverse cities in the world and as a result boasts one of the most eclectic dining scenes. Whichever cuisine takes your fancy, London has a variety of restaurants capable of taking your breath away. The best restaurants focus on ingredients and craft, whether it's hand-rolled pasta or fiery clay pot cooking. Our picks for where to eat runs from Michelin-starred dining rooms to tiny neighborhood joints, some serving exquisite tasting menus, some serving versions of down-home food that span several continents. Whatever you do though, just make sure you show up hungry. Here are our 10 picks for the best restaurants in London. Let's start. Number 1. Clove Club. Set behind a glossy blue door in Shoreditch's stately old town hall, fuss and frills are out at this Michelin-starred joint, but the tasting menu is dizzyingly ambitious. Plates are rooted in impeccably sourced seasonal British produce and fizzing with ideas, while house cocktails are just as creative. It's always busy, but a seat at the candlelit, cozy bar works just as well. Number 2. Bow Fitzrovia. At Bow Fitzrovia you'll walk into an airy, stripped-back space, with stools around a U-shaped bar, where waiters will hand you a tick-box menu and a pencil. Naturally, you should start with a plump, pillowy bow or two, but don't neglect the small plates or the larger main dishes, one should be enough for two people. Drop by for a quick dinner with friends, or a solo lunch at the bar. The expanded drinks menu features cocktails, sakis, whiskies, wines and milkshakes. Number 3. Kiln. Take a front row seat at the counter to see Chef Medusard's rustic Thai food come together over fire and embers, like the charred, cumin-dusted aged lamb skewers we always order on arrival. The food is excellently made every single time. Watching the chefs cook away from behind the bar is a fun experience too. Ingredients on the short, changing menu here are impeccably sourced, from Cornish seafood, delivered fresh each day, to British-grown Thai and Chinese herbs. The turmeric-laced red mullet's a must, if it's on the menu, double the raw langoustines, spiked with mint and kaffir lime. Number 4. Rochelle Canteen. Buckingham Palace may be just up the road, but Rochelle Canteen is strictly low-key, a buzzing ground-floor sake bar and mezzanine restaurant, with white walls and Alvar Aalto furniture. The menu changes daily but might include things like a harissa-spiced quail or a handsome pheasant and trotter pie. Monday lunch of leftovers but is wonderfully tender, rosemary fragranced meat and perky leaves slicked with the umami hum of green herbs and anchovy. This place is an excellent all-rounder, a few minutes walk from Trafalgar Square and the perfect venue for a date that won't seem like you're trying too hard. Number 5. Cricket. At this youthful, buzzy, two-floor Soho spot, you'll find Indian-inspired food made from best of British ingredients, which means things like cinnamon-spiced venison keema, tandoori grouse with cocoa bean masala, or Barkswell cheese and chili top culture, a soft, pillowy bread, cooked in the tandoor oven, and essential for soaking up sauces. Cricket now operates 3 permanent locations in Brixton, Soho and White City. Service is on point, with dishes arriving almost instantly. That means you can keep adding to your order without slowing things down, squeezing in another dish or two before hitting the masala chai. Booking as a group means you can make a reservation, cut the line, and get to taste most of the menu, but it's also fun to come with a date and squeeze in at the counter to watch the chefs do their thing. Number 6. Spring. Set in the grandly neoclassical Somerset House. Spring offers up a dreamy dining room, all pastel hues, Italian marble, and blossoming wall art, light-filled in the daytime, softly luminous at night. Stick to the simple main courses to get the best from the kitchen. A generous chunk of steamed turbot served on a bed of cucumber, with an exemplary béarnaise is as unfussy as can be, yet delivers a lovely balance. So too does fillet steak, served Italian style with salsa verde. Though perfectly grilled lamb cutlets with aubergine gratin somehow lose their intensity through the buildup of herbs and spices. A dozen changing starters and mains showcase the best of what's in season, often grown on Fern Vero's 16-acre biodynamic farm. Dishes often hue Italian, but sky gingel is a culinary magpie, so labneh, persimmon and fermented chilies also find a place on her menus. It's a deliciously grown-up place to come for dinner, expensive, quietly elegant, and oblivious to trends. Number 7. Black Axe Mangal. Black Axe is a tiny, low-lit joint with a serious heavy metal habit. The vibe is dive bar meets Chinese takeaway, with black and gold walls, waving lucky cats, and floral plastic tablecloths, and there's serious talent in that small kitchen in the form of Lee Tiernan. Black Axe Mangal is filled with many more juicy details, making it the kind of cookbook you may well find yourself reaching for again and again, especially when you invite friends over. Come for a dinner big on flavors, spices, and offal, with every component slow-cooked, crafted, or smoked in-house, or a more kid-friendly brunch of cinnamon banana flatbreads. Service is fast, friendly, and suitably rock and roll. Number 8. Padella. When the food's this good and the prices are this restrained, you won't mind waiting in line to get on the waiting list. With plates of pasta priced between £4 and £11.50, Padella is already super affordable. This no reservations, edge of Borough Market pasta bar is a favorite of the pasta obsessed, and a place where a plateful of the peachy cacio e pepe is a must and aperitivi are a steal, with inexpensive spritzes, Negroni, and Prosecco by the glass. It's perfect for a comforting carb fix, and a great place for dinner and a catch-up. Number 9. Gloria. It's all about the good time vibes at the first London restaurant from Big Mama Group, whose Paris locations have conquered the city's dining scene. But what of the food? Again, it's fun. Get the carbonara for two. It arrives on a trolley in a parmesan wheel, where it's twirled and whirled around, picking up more bits of cheese along the way, then finally lifted high and plopped onto each plate. Rich and Moorish, its creamy, peppery, cheese-flecked sauce also came studded with morsels of guanciale, cured pork. True, it was a tad salty, but the spaghetti had been carefully cooked, and really, who can argue with a plate of pasta rich in just chipped parmesan? Gloria is audacious but impossible to resist, a pastiche of a 50s trattoria transplanted to a Shoreditch Street corner. The menu is indulgent to say the least, truffled burrata, luscious carbonara theatrically mixed inside a wheel of pecorino, or a tangle of Mavalda pasta loaded with black truffles. Number 10. Pigeon. Behind a discreet grey frontage, Pigeon is understated but buzzing, and its tiny size belies its big ambitions. A cozy, single-room restaurant with understated decor and a buzzy neighborhood vibe, tucked away on a residential Hackney Street. Creative modern British dishes deliver an array of different textures and flavors. The no-choice menu changes weekly, as do the interesting wine pairings. Dishes, which change every week, artfully riff on texture as well as taste, like Jerusalem artichoke cooked three ways and served with silky miso custard. With the same four courses at lunch and dinner, this must be one of London's shortest menus, but the dishes are complex, artfully balanced, with flavors that linger in the mind. So that's it for today. What are your thoughts on today's video? Have you visited any of these restaurants? Which of the above restaurants would you like to visit? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed watching today's video and would like to hear more from us, please subscribe to this channel and turn on notification bell before you go. Thank you for watching us.